Thank you, Stephen, for that lovely song. Does anybody know how hard it is to come up here and try to sing a song all by yourself? That's very hard. Stephen, that was amazing. Okay, so far we've had a message from Peter. Can anybody tell me? I want to make sure you guys are all awake. There's no reason to be sleepy. It's not Sunday morning. So what was Peter's message about? Anybody? We'll take hands. What was Peter's? Let's see, Adele. I know you were listening. Adults, anyone. What was Peter's message about? Anybody? Gracie. The wise men gave gifts to Jesus, and he took each of those gifts and broke it down for you, just in case you didn't know before. So now you learned something new. And then we had a lovely song. Next, we're going to have a special passage that is going to be recited by our very own Thomas.
Luke chapter 2, verses 8. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, Christ. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
For that passage from Luke. I think that's something we all really need to remember during this Christmas time. The fact that Jesus was born on Christmas Day to save us from our sins. And it was a beautiful passage that he read. And our next program is a brother and sister collaboration. I think you know them really well. I'd like to welcome Tina and John.